If you use backing tracks on stage, I want to ask you one question. What are you going to do if something goes wrong? Hey, this is Will Doggett. Today, I want to show you how to set up the PlayAudio12. One, it's just a normal 10 or 12 output audio interface. And then two, and most importantly, how to use it to create a really simple, affordable, redundant playback rig. So let's get started. So let's talk about the first thing you should do when you pull your PlayAudio12 out of the box. Obviously, plug it into your computer, check for any firmware updates. But what I'm going to do is use the Oracle software to make sure the gains on all my outputs are turned up. So I've included the link to Oracle in the description so you can download it. It's an easy brand new software control from iConnectivity. I'm going to go in and you see PlayAudio12 show up here. I'm going to do select device. And what I want to do is just confirm that all my output gains are turned up. What I've seen sometimes with PlayAudio12 is when I plug them in, I don't get audio immediately. And it's because my gains are turned down. So I would suggest plug in your audio interface. One, confirm that you don't have a firmware update. If you bought it brand new, you probably do because it's been sitting in a box. And then two, make sure your gains are turned up. Now, let's start talking about this just as a normal audio interface and not for redundancy. So as a normal audio interface, it's an incredible solution. You can have 10 to 12 outputs. You can use the headphone outputs left and right as 11 and 12 if you want to, or you can use just the 10 outputs on the back. It does a lot of really cool stuff. You can share it between machines, so you could use tracks on this machine, keys on this machine, split them 6 and 6. We won't talk about that in this video. Super simple to do, or you can just use it as a 10 or 12 output interface. I'm going to show you how to do that. So I've got it connected to this machine. I've got Ableton Live open. And what I want to do is press Command Comma to configure this audio interface. So I'm going to go to the Audio tab here. And under Audio Output Device, I'm going to select PlayAudio12. So if the PlayAudio12 selected as my output, I want to configure my output. So I'm going to click Output Config. And you see I have the option to choose either mono outputs or stereo outputs. For the sake of this, I'm just going to use mono outputs. Here's one of the most important things to remember if you're using this as just a normal standard audio interface, is make sure you don't use outputs 13 and 14. That's just for sensing tone for a redundant rig. So what I'm going to do is just go ahead and turn off outputs 13 and 14. If you're not using the headphone output, then go ahead and disable 11 and 12 as well. I'm going to hit OK. Now, obviously, there's tons of other options like naming outputs I could do in Ableton Live. I never do that. So I can adjust my buffer size here. Again, not going to talk about that, but I've got my interface selected and I'm ready to go. So I could go in, and in this case, I've got return tracks set up, and I'm going to route those return tracks to outputs on my interface. So I'll do external out. I could do one. Let's just do a couple of these for now. Again, I've linked to the video on showing how to set up an audio interface where I go a little more in depth to this. Let's just do a couple of these return tracks now. So the first and most important thing to remember when you're using this as a normal audio interface is, again, do not route to outputs 13 and 14. The second most important thing is on the front panel, make sure that the Scene A button is lit up, which means it's green. And that means it's expecting input on the A side or input one. So I'm gonna make sure I plug my computer into input one. Right now, I have both machines connected, because I'm gonna talk about redundancy in a moment. But I just want to make sure I connect this computer to the A side, to Scene A, input one, and make sure that my light is green. Now, if I've done all that, then when I press play, I'm going to have output coming out of all my outputs. And again, they're all discrete outputs. So one is one, all the way to 12 being 12, which is great. So super straightforward, super easy to do. Now, if you're looking to use headphones 11 and 12 as separate discrete outs, you're going to have to go into iConfig and make some changes. I'm not going to talk about this in that video, but at least this will get you going with 10 outputs really easily. But now back to that important question of having a backup plan. If you use backing tracks live, you've got to have some sort of backing plan. You have to have some plan for redundancy. Using a PlayAudio12 makes this incredibly simple and easy to do. So let's talk about how we have this connected. One, I have my main machine connected to the first input here. So this is input A. And then my second backup machine is connected to input B using USB. And the way I want to trigger both these machines at the same time so they're in sync is using an Akai LPK25. I've got a USB cable plugged in here into the USB host port, and I'm just going to grab my MIDI controller. Okay, so I'm going to set my MIDI controller here so I can get to it easily. So with my MIDI controller connected, I'm going to go in and make just a couple configurations, then I'm going to do my MIDI mapping. So let's do Command Comma on both of these machines. We're going to go to the Link MIDI tab. And what I want to do, I'm going to start on my A machine, is I want to go to the input side here, and for USB 101, which is my host port, which is what this is connected to, I want to make sure that remote is enabled because I want to remotely control Ableton Live from this controller. Do the same thing over here. I'm going to go to my second machine where it says input PlayAudio12 host one, and I want to make sure that remote is enabled. No matter what yours says, whether it says USB 101 or host one, make sure it's that first port if you're using this with the host port. So now with remote enabled, I'm going to close down this. I want to go to MIDI map mode, Command M on both these machines. And you see I've already made some MIDI mappings, but let me just delete the one for play and I'll show you how I did this. So on both machines, I'm going to click play and then I'm going to press this button and you'll see it maps on both of my machines at the same time. Now, I've linked to the video below that shows how to set up a MIDI controller with Ableton Live, and I explain a little bit why I prefer doing custom mappings like this as opposed to using remote scripts. With that set up, let's press Command M to get out of MIDI map mode. So now the way this works, we haven't talked about audio output at redundancy yet, but essentially what I can do now is when I press play, it's gonna start both of my machines at the same time. I can press stop and it's going to stop both of my machines at the same time. And then as I talked about in our MIDI mapping for live performance video, which I've also linked below, there's four mappings I have: play, stop, previous locator, next locator. So I can play both machines and then I can skip ahead a few locators and both of my machines are going to follow those commands at the same time. So super, super cool. So that's how I'm triggering both of them at the same time. Now let's talk about the redundancy aspect of this. So essentially there's two ways to do redundancy. One, we can have automatic redundancy, which is what most people are going to use and prefer because it's pretty hands-off. Or we can do manual redundancy. That's what I personally prefer. If you've seen the video I did a couple years ago when I was at Sweetwater talking about building a redundant rig, I showed you how I use a radial SW8 to do this similar thing, make this happen, but I did it manually. That's what I prefer, using a foot switch, but I'm gonna show you both really quickly. So let's talk about it from the manual perspective. So if I'm doing this manually, I'm still gonna set up my MIDI controller. I'm still gonna trigger both machines. There's essentially two ways to switch manually. One, if you have the interface next to you, you can see by default, scene A is green. If I wanna switch to the scene B computer or computer two, all I do is just press the touch panel. So when it turns from green to red, it means you're now on machine B. If you want to switch back to machine A, all you have to do is press the front panel again. Now, the second way, and probably the best way to switch manually if you're going to use this interface, is to plug in a foot controller to the input on the front panel. This is going to allow you to, when you press the foot controller, it's going to switch again from A to B, and when you're ready to switch back, you can press it again to switch back to your A machine. So while I prefer doing this manually, again, I know most people are interested in doing this automatically. So the best way to do this automatically is to install the LifeSign plugin from iConnectivity. It's completely free, and I've included the link to download it in the description of this video. So on my A machine, I only need to do this on my A machine. I want to make sure that I've installed the plugin, which I have. If it's the first time you've done this, go to Preferences and Live, Command Comma, go to File Folder and make sure you have your plugin set up set correctly, whether you're using VST, AU, System Folders, or Custom Folders. So I have that enabled. I'm going to go to Plugins here in the browser and go to LifeSign. And I'm just going to drop this right into my set. And again, I only need to do it on this machine, not my backup machine. So the trick to making this happen is, remember, when we use this as a normal interface, we want to skip outputs 13 and 14. But when we use this for redundancy, then we're going to use outputs 13 and 14 to basically track this sine wave. So here's what we do. One, I'm going to go back in and re-enable those outputs because if you remember earlier, I disabled them. So I'm going to press audio there, go to output config, and I want to re-enable outputs 13 and 14 and hit OK. So close that, and then I'm going to go over to session view just because I prefer seeing it this way. And in the audio 2 section, I want to change it from master to external out. So we're going to select external out, and then I'm going to take this and send this to 13. Now, watch the front panel of this box. And you're going to see the light turn from green to, if I have it configured correctly, it's going to start flashing green. So when it's flashing green, that means that it's receiving tone from the LifeSign plugin. And again, even when my playback in Ableton is stopped, it's seeing and sensing the plugin. So now I can go back to my set I've got the same set opened up. I'm gonna press stop so that I go back to the first measure of my song. I can press play so that my songs start together. Again, my light is flashing green. And then let's switch to our backup machine. We're doing this automatically. So let's see the most possible destructive way we can make this happen. Let's just rip out our USB cable. There we go. It's gone, and you see it automatically switches to our B machine. When our light turns red, that means that we're on the B machine. Everything's still running, it's still going, the show can still happen. Your laptop could be on the ground, your USB cable could be unplugged, and things are still going to work. So again, as a reminder, if you're using tracks on stage, you have to have a backup plan, and there's no better backup plan than the PlayAudio 12. Now, if you wanna learn how to do much more than this with the PlayAudio 12, connect it to a MIDI 4 Plus, a Mia 4, do lots of really cool things, I'd encourage you to head to fromstudiostage.com/PlayAudio12. And there I've put together a link of all the tutorials and courses I've done on this box so that you can master this and walk into any gig confident that you have a backup plan and the show is gonna keep running. So again, head to fromstudiostage.com/PlayAudio12 to check out all the courses and tutorials. Thanks so much for watching this. See you guys next week. Take care. Bye.